Hi everyone, my name is Robert Rich and I'm one of your deputy superintendents here in Melissa ISD. I have the opportunity to present you with an introductory video that gives you a little bit of an idea of what to expect from the back to school plan that we released later this week. In short, I'll tell you that this is my 15th or 16th year here in Melissa, and these are definitely some of the most challenging and unique times that we've seen here in our community. We're very, very grateful to our city leadership who has managed our community during these trying times, as well as our parents and students and community members that have given us feedback and worked collaboratively as well. Now we'd like to talk to you for a few minutes about some of the processes that we've worked through beginning last spring and through the summer. We know that many of you would have liked to have had a detailed plan in place and a lot of information prior to now. One of our concerns has been that we needed to see the guiding information come together in a way that didn't create an environment in our community where we had to disseminate plans and then go back and change them. Just in the last week and a half to 2 weeks, we feel like we have gotten good guidance from our Commissioner of Education that feels somewhat summative. We've gotten some good guidance from the governor. County and local health official guidance is all starting to align. And then, of course, many of the things that we work on and prepare for are governed by UIL guidelines as well. So there's a lot of information that we needed to pull together. We feel like that has all come together, which then led us to the opportunity to sit down and share some of that with our parents and staff members and formulate a few additional plans from there. Now that all that information has come together, we started to work from what we thought of as a general perspective to a specific perspective. In other words, we sent out a couple of surveys to our parents to get general information. That helped us narrow our thinking and try to align that with our parents. We then invited several parent groups in to meet with us, give feedback based on what we had heard generally, take their feedback and guidance, and refine a little bit more. Right after that, we had the opportunity to survey our staff generally with the same process, work from the general to the specific, and to get their concerns and then meet with them individually and to hone that into information that can be taken to the campuses for individual plans. Now, we need to keep in mind that our staff is very dutiful. And one of the things that we learned in our surveys was that our staff wants to be here, our staff wants to come back, but just like anyone in the regular community, our staff has concerns. We have staff members whose immune systems are compromised because of cancer treatments. We have staff members who are caretakers of elderly family members who are concerned about contracting COVID and taking that home to them. We have staff members who are expecting children and have small children, and they're concerned about contracting COVID and taking it to those children or passing it on potentially in the womb. Those are all things that we need to prepare for. And our staff is ready to receive kids, but we want to make sure that we're ready to also provide them with the precautions that make them feel safe and enable them to do their jobs effectively. Some of the things that we learned from parents included they're ready for their kids to come back to school. They're concerned about the break in educational experience, and they want some normalcy as soon as possible. We are trying to reconcile the wide variety of opinions in our community. We feel like we have come up with a plan that will give people choices and will allow people to participate where they're comfortable and allow them to elect not to participate in some areas where they're not. Again, with the idea that trying to put a square peg through a round hole, this doesn't feel like normal school 100%, but we're very excited about where we're going and we're looking forward to releasing that plan to you in the coming days. In terms of our back to school plan specifically, we're looking at a 2-week phase-in. Now there's a rationale for that. First of all, we all know that we may come to school in the fall and we may end up under a mandate to close schools again for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, a month, 2 months. It's really hard to predict the future. Certainly we're under a mandate right now to open schools and to come back, and so we're preparing for that. It's important for us in the very first week of our back to school plan that every student gets set up on our new virtual platform. Now this virtual platform is much more robust than what you experienced last spring. We've had a little bit more time to prepare now and to work that option into shape, and to hopefully will be a more engaging environment as needed. Once we have everybody set up on that during the first week, then during the second week of school, we will start to phase particular grade levels back in. That will give our staff a chance to practice guidelines and cleaning and protocols that are new to them with smaller groups of students. It'll allow us to put some procedures into place with those grade levels to work those students in. And then by the third week of school, everyone who wants to be back to school in person will be back to school full time. And anyone who elects to continue virtual education will still have that option as well. Now keep in mind, if I go back to that first week of school, there may be some select groups that we pull in that first week that we need to make sure we take a little extra time to give them the opportunity to acclimate themselves to these new procedures. Perhaps some of our special needs classrooms or some of our co-curricular activities that just come in spot type situations. But by the time we get through week two, everyone who wants to be back will be back and we'll be ready to go. In closing, because goodness knows, nobody wants to sit and watch a 30-minute video about a plan that's going to be introduced that isn't even introduced in the video. We know, as has already been mentioned, that we're under a mandate to open. We understand that we're not going to have answers that please everyone, but I just can't tell you how grateful we are for our community. The support that we've seen locally, the planning, the collaboration. We are also aware that educators are identified as essential employees and we have an obligation to come back. Not that we just want to come back, we have an obligation to come back and to do so safely and effectively. We're ready to do that. In a time of turmoil in our world, in a lot of arenas, in a lot of areas, is there any more time when we are all so blessed to live in a community like Melissa, where collectively we strive for unity and purpose more than we do division? We are so grateful for you. Most of all, we are grateful for your children, and we look forward to the opportunity to work with them. If you have specific concerns, I hope that you will feel that our doors are always open. Call, email, we can set up individual times to meet and discuss any concerns that you may have. Best wishes, we look forward to getting back to some sense of normalcy, and we look forward to having all of our cardinals back in the nest.